day at the circus is always a big event, but it's doubly exciting when there's an extra added attraction. The scene is New York's Madison Square Garden, and the young lady atop the ponderous pachyderm is Miss Joyce McDougal of England. But not for long. She will be Mrs. Brahman Bin Lassen, and the bride-to-be does a frantic frug just to prove that she's all shook up. The ceremony takes place in the center ring, and one of the circus clowns, Prince Paul, is the tiny ring bearer. Now, a more properly demure Miss McDougal, in the traditional gown and veil, is escorted down the aisle by Henry Ringling North, and she's met by the groom, a native of Morocco, who is an acrobat and production man. The double ring, center ring ceremony is witnessed by the couple's fellow performers who attend the wedding dressed in their circus costumes. The bride and groom have been with the circus for a combined 10 years. The ring goes on, the circus troopers look misty-eyed, and the couple unite for the traditional embrace and kiss before a matinee audience of 15,000 guests. Talk about big wedding receptions. And so this exotic marriage is made, and here's one couple who are not kidding when they say, our marriage is just one big circus. The beloved baggy pants tramp with the derby and cane upstages a chuckling Charlie Chaplin celebrating his 77th birthday on the London set of Universal's A Countess from Hong Kong. And he's joined by stars Sophia Loren, Tippi Hedren, and an army of cameramen. Mrs. Chaplin, the former Una O'Neill, looks just as pleased as Charlie, while daughters Josephine and Victoria make it a family portrait. Sultry Sophia and co-star Sidney Chaplin, Charlie's son, stand near the gigantic cake while champagne is being opened and the cameras continue to click. Charlie said it was the best possible birthday because it found him, in his words, doing what I enjoy most, making a film. Sophia's lacy legs and lovely face add to the party mood while veteran movie maker John Huston offers personal congratulations. A wonderful day in the life of Charlie Chaplin, screen immortal, whose incredible career spans over half a century. No, it's no invasion by the little green men from Mars. What you're looking at is an invention of a Dutch machine manufacturer. He calls it the Amphorol, and as you can see, there's hardly anything it can't do. Hey, Mom, how'd you like those tracks across the living room rug? Its maneuverability is fantastic, and the driver can even use a combination of switches to make it ride sideways like a crab. Mud, quicksand, even water is a cinch for this amphibious monster, which has caught the interest of U.S. military authorities as a possible replacement for tanks. And this is the British Army's new six-wheel gun and personnel carrier, able to slosh through shallow rivers and lakes with no trouble and descend all but impossible slopes without danger of overturning. It has a slick suspension system, independent springing on each wheel, which would be the envy of all motorists. Looks great, but I hate the thought of getting a flat tire in that thing on a lonely road late at night. Hold onto your hats and batten down the hatches for one of the wildest and wackiest of the new speed sports, bump and bang jalopy racing. This one features both American and British daredevils at Brands Hatch, England. Hold the phone, and while you're at it, call a good body shop or fender repair man. Wow, so that's what they mean by barreling along. Actually, the oil barrels give the drivers more trouble than other drivers. These cars, powered by huge engines, are unusually safe, and injuries among the drivers are surprisingly rare. Average speeds hit 70 miles per hour, and that ain't loafing. The crowd loves it, and why not? They're not in it. The cars continue to knock over the oil barrels like tenpins in a bowling alley, while the drivers battle, bump, and blast their way around the cinder track like kids at Coney Island. Driver Alan Briggs gets the checkered flag, and for my money, a medal for bravery.